G'day everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today we will be looking at yet another Rise to War video, but today we will be giving an update on the server progress of the season. Currently playing on campaign season 5, we're currently playing Tactics Evolved and it's currently server 85. So if we take a brief look at the map, we'll just take a quick overview before delving more into faction specific stuff. So as of new, we have Osgiliath and Harrendor have now been taken by the Variags. Obviously, heavy fighting ensuing around the Harrendor Island and some of the crossings. Up north, you have Ruin still remaining pretty much the same. A little bit of clash with Rohan up north, but other than that, pretty similar. Gundabad and Erebor. So for Erebor, you obviously don't have much fighting against Gundabad, if at any at all. And Erebor is largely focused on moving over to help their new ally, Loth. So with the United Factions feature coming up, Loth and Erebor will ally, and they look to be likely, as they are, the vote is currently heavily in favour of them. Gundabad and Variags is the other one that we know of currently that is pretty much set and certain, with Variags and Gundabad currently already in the voting stage, and it is at 100% for Variags last I checked. We will double check in a moment though. Obviously you have a heavy fighting between the Gundabad and Arnor up here, and obviously shadowed by Linden moving into the Eden Moor's Keep. Does help to throw things a little bit more in the balance. Lothlorien is a completely different story, ravaged by battle both by the Rohirrim in the south and by Linden and Arnor in the west. Obviously this does cause very much a big problem for them. They are outnumbered, with their ally or United Faction partner in Erebor taking a long time to come over just because of the geography of the map. However, once they will arise, that will help fix up the balance and fix up the lopsided fight over here. It is important to notice that Linden has taken Dunferin, owning now the Dunland area from the Lothlorien, thus putting obviously Isengard and allowing them this quicker reinforcement area between Rohan and Gondor, who are also heavily fighting Variags at the moment. For Rohan, obviously they have lost the Keeps of Estimate and they've lost the Argonath Crossing, which you'll see when we zoom in. Both have fallen now to the Variags. Obviously, through a number of events that led to that and a long, drawn-out couple of fights. With Arnor and Linden now looking very much like allies, I do not believe they're a United Faction, though. The current indication is that Linden will United Faction with Rohan to increase the two strongest good side factions, other than Lothlorien and Erebor, to ally and allow them greater freedom to fight against the Variags, Loth, Erebor, and Orca / Gundabad alliance. As you take a look though, as we come south, obviously Rohirrim and Gondor are good allies and they will continue to fight relentlessly against the Variags. Let's look at some of the more strategic in-depth things now. First, obviously Osgiliath has just fallen. This has fallen less than an hour ago now, and if we take a look at it, there will still be a lot of action going around. Now, an important thing to note about Osgiliath is that the attack was very well coordinated, in that the attack was staged from well behind the line of sight and in the fog of war for Gondor, so they could not see the armies amassing, which did allow us to take it with relatively low snipe chance from Gondor. Obviously, as you can see now, it's just going to be a long drawn out battle of taking the keeps, because as you can see, this is an Arnorian which is owned by the Minas Tirith keep, therefore we will have reduced siege damage, we'll have a negative 70% modifier there. As for Harrendor, Harrendor fell after a couple of days fighting, and as we come over to look at the Harrendor resource island, we do see that there is a little bit of fighting over here. I believe at this point in time though, most of it has been mopped up, yet with the last few tiles being cleaned up now, so that will see thick fighting there. There was a lot of tense fighting over here as Gondor tried to resist. It is obviously a good source of resources for them, and as such very, very valuable to them, so they did try and keep it for as long as they could. Now as we look north, obviously Ruin is looking for a United Faction partner, currently believed to be going with Isengard, and then leaving that Mordor and Angmar, the two smallest evil factions, could then United Factions with one another, allowing this gap to fill the map, allowing all of evil to get onto this left-hand side of the map to start to fight against this Arnor Linden side of the battle. The important thing to note for Rohan is that they are getting pushed from Variags, and obviously with Emin Muil going after the snipe at the crossings over here near Argonath. At Argonath there was a standoff where obviously you had Rohan on this side. Rohan did declare war and promptly take this crossing, as they needed war because it was based in Emin Muil, which was a very, very important factor. Upon them taking it and they came over to start sieging our side, we sniped our side once the 1 hour had expired. We proceeded to take the critical crossing on their side, thus allowing us to push over and clear their side. This not only allowed us the ability to obviously start pushing them back, but it also meant that with that we did not need war to do so. We could save our war for a later time. And it also meant that as we pushed them back for 24 hours, their war ended, they could not effectively retake their side of the crossing, causing a permanent leak of our forces over the crossings. Argonath was obviously taken from the spectacle fort nearby, and obviously without Rohan owning a serious connection. And at the time that we took it, they did not own this crossing. There was zero snipe chance from Rohan without us seeing them take the crossing. And obviously it is about a 10-minute march at the best of times. So it is a 12-minute march from this fort up here. So I'd estimate it'd be about 10 to 12-minute walk from the other side of the crossing to here. So it would be a very, very hard keep to snipe for Gondor to do. They would have to be guessing and marching about 10 minutes in advance. Very, very rough timing to do. If we look at things from the perspective of Variax, obviously United Faction, there is our 100% vote agree at the moment. Obviously this could change, but it does look like it'll get passed through no matter what anyone else says. As to do with the Linden fight, obviously Linden has now lost Dunland, which does make it a bit harder for them. As you can see, Linden has proven themselves to be a very, very effective fighting force. And despite the lack of experience, or the thought to be lack of experience, they fought very well as a team, supported by some ex-Gondor members and a few other members from other factions. They do have the ability to keep pumping out this fight. With Lothlorien having drawn out because of the drawn-out battles with both Rohan and Arnor, they were unable to effectively continue to hold them off, with Linden assaulting them from multiple sides. They were able to take back this area up here, again, but this is another fight against Arnor. And with Arnor now being distracted up in the north, that should start to even out in the following days. The key points to note for the future of this server, and from the tactical point of view, is that Linden has a very, very strong front and should be seen as the spear of this alliance with Arnor, Rohan, and Gondor. And obviously they need to drive Loth out of this corner of the map, and obviously the northern two keeps of Agmar and Gundabad, to effectively secure their borders and allow them to start hitting crossings and other places needed to breach them. And this does give them a little bit of security if they can do so. But the most important thing to note, Gondor and Rohan are in a serious cause of panic at the moment, or not cause of panic, but they're in a situation of panic at the moment, where whether they like it or not, they are forced to decide what they want to do now. Their hand is relatively forced, they have to act quickly, with both Edoras and Minas Tirith now within striking range of the Variags. It does mean that you obviously have to make a call of what you're going to do here. With Arnor and Gondor likely to be the other two good side United factions together, it does look like Gondor will probably have to head up into this top left-hand corner to fight in Arnor lands, to fight against Lothlorien and obviously Erebor when Erebor turns up. As for Rohan, when they're United faction with Linden, they will probably make a tactical call whether to continue to fight against Variax and obviously slow down our advance, or whether they make an immediate move into the lands of Linden. Now this could play out a number of ways. Obviously they would delay, but at this moment it does not look like they'll be able to halt the Variax advance, but they might still be able to delay it. Same with Gondor, they could hope to delay it, but at this moment it does not seem like they'd be able to stop the endless march. However, if they were all to go up into the top left, they would be giving up regions to the Variax and securing the entire eastern area to the essentially Variags slash evil and obviously Erebor and Loth, allowing Loth some freedom of super farming lands back here, which would allow them to recover any potential losses. Now, obviously, with Minas Tirith within immediate striking range, Gondor will have to make their call very, very soon. As you can see, we are currently breaching forts, and we're currently attacking the crossing that is next to Minas Tirith, forcing them into a very, very harsh spot. And it is expected that within perhaps a day or two, maybe less, they will obviously United Faction, and they will move on from there. So it does look like some very, very interesting times ahead. Most importantly to note, though, there has been a number of incidents with people or players from both sides, again sitting in world chat, obviously most likely rogues or spy accounts, who have been committing toxicity in the chats, and by all means that is not encouraged. It is definitely not encouraged to spread false rumors or lies about factions to try and flip them. I do not encourage that by any means. In my opinion, if a faction chooses to ally one way or another, no matter how you look at it and whose side you look at it, one side will always like a faction and the other won't. For example, if we take a loss, for example, in the season, not saying this is how it is, but this is how it could be viewed. Variags obviously have Loth as an ally. They like Loth. Whereas good side sees Loth as perhaps a traitor to the good side fight, or however more, and that does bring out this kind of sense of hatred, and this can lead to toxicity, mulch, and insults against players. Again, people play for their own reasons, and you have to respect that. Most importantly, though, you have Lothlorien. If they were to flip, they would be seen as the heroes from good side, and seen by as betrayers by evil. So again, just keep in mind that you might dislike a faction, but again, if they were to flip, would you still like them before making any comments? Because a lot of the times it is done to flip factions, and that kind of toxicity just ruins the game for a lot of people. With that being said, that seems to be the update on the server, and I'll be keeping everyone up to date and hopefully doing a few more of these. All right, enjoy the rest of your day, everyone, and thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.